Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen, Pastor Joanne. The Lord has spoken with me very, very profoundly and extensively about this glorious meeting that's coming up in Nakuru, the powerful revival of Jehovah visiting Nakuru very soon. And the Lord of hosts, he has spoken with me by taking me into that meeting. I've seen that meeting already, and I see powerful healing anointing that is going to come. I have not seen this type before. So this is going to be a historic visitation again that will bring the love of God, the love of his grace, the grace and mercy of the Lord to the nation of Kenya and to many other nations that will partake of this visitation. I see a huge, huge healing anointing that will totally cover the entire field. This night the Lord showed me this. And this type of fresh anointing I have not seen before. And so that means, again, Kenya will set another record in the disposition of love that God has brought upon her. And, of course, the nations that will partake will be involved. And then at one point, the Lord assembled many people with many kinds of conditions. And he healed them all. He healed them all. And I see a very large number of cancer patients that are in very deplorable and terrible condition. Their situation is not very good. And I see the Lord, he assembled them also within that shocking anointing. And then the prophet of the Lord prayed before the Lord. They lined up at one point. I thought I saw them line up. The man of God walked into the field. He prayed, and when he walked into the field, and then the Lord healed them. The Lord healed a large number of cancer patients also. And so it was a very, very shocking and historic moment to behold in that meeting. And I've seen historic healing anointing like never before, not before, a shocking visitation of the Lord in Nakuru. And the Lord, the God of heaven, of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ and our Father, he has decided that during this time, as the nations prepare for the wonderful, blessed coming of the Blessed One of Israel, whose name is Christ Jesus the Messiah, that as the Blessed One of Israel prepares to come, that he is going to love the nations and is going to remove them, to bring remission to the pain that the church is going through. The people are suffering. So I have seen this, and this is going to be a mighty, mighty visitation like never before. So Kisumu was very big. Kisumu was absolutely very big. The last meeting, the end of year meeting in Kisumu. In fact, even yesterday I was receiving new pictures and new testimonies of cripples and lunatics that were healed. Crippled babies that are now walking, they were sending, the bishop was sending pictures from their different jurisdictions of the many cripples that walked in Kisumu that we did not manage to reach. Babies that were totally, their hands like ropes and legs weak like a rope and foot, now walking. Those pictures arrived yesterday. I saw them for the first time also. So Kisumu was really very big. Was so big and historic on its own merit, and we could not reach all the healed. However, now what the Lord has spoken with me about this night, and this being 6 a.m. in the morning, East African time, 6 in the morning, this night, what the Lord has spoken about regarding the visitation of his healing anointing to Nakuru. Now, this is almost 1,000-fold what you saw in Kisumu. So I see the Lord deliberately but consistently and gradually intending to do a humongous thing that the earth has not seen before. Because I see a healing of a large number of people, crippled, many blind, many deaf, many mute, many paralytics, the lame leg to be stretched, strengthened the feet put on the ground. People that have been on their toes, now he will stretch them like he did in French Guiana, where this lady, this my daughter, was walking on her toes because the foot was short. Then in a 2.5 minute prayer, he pulled the leg. She felt a physical hand touch the leg, pulled it down, and finally stepped on the ground. And so she was jumping with me in that meeting. She was able to jump first time. Anyhow, so this kind of event is going to take the team, but at a greater magnitude. I've seen the highest anointing of the healing, that the healing of the Lord that's going to pour, literally pour and overflood. And this is going to saturate, based on what he has shown me this night, is literally going to saturate the entire field of the meeting, including people that will be out in the hospitals tuned in by radio, those that will be out there in their homes tuned in by radio, watching by TV. But this is going to be one of the biggest meetings on the entire earth. So I'm announcing that the biggest visitation in the history of church, the history of the Bible, is indeed about to take place. It's going to take place in Nakuru, where the Spirit is going to test the power of the grace. He's going to bring to bear, he's going to bring to reality the promise of the latter outpour of grace, the latter outpour of the glory of Jehovah. And this is going to be a healing anointing like none other before. And so, I saw already yesterday, again, how people were preparing, people were running, and everybody was saying, oh, I want a place in the bus, I want a place in the car. Each one was saying, we're leaving. Some people are leaving the evening, other buses were leaving the morning. I saw, he showed me the entire nation mobilizing to go and be before the Lord, be in the sacred assembly of Jehovah. Now, this is essentially the stripe. These are the stripes of the latter humongous, unmatched revival the Bible promised. And this is now what we are dealing with at this hour. However, the detail of is very scary, it's very shocking. Because now you see huge healing anointing, even as the harvesting of souls, the nation, entire nation mobilizing. I have seen a lot of now they have sent me from different towns and villages and where it, some places it has reached door-to-door mobilization. They're saying, bring out the sick, bring out your cripples, do you have the deaf here? And such a thing has never happened on the whole earth in the history of the earth. Do you have any blind here? Do you have any cripple here? Please, can you give us the cripple? And taking pictures of these people right from the beginning on the ground, right now, the pastor, the bishop. Well, that is the meaning of the latter revival that was promised. But to get into the detail of it now, the humongous baptism that is sweeping the land right now, people are repenting, returning to Jesus, and being baptized. Yeah? And people are salvation where they had fallen back to sin. And we are seeing now also the disposition of love, the healing anointing that the Lord has now decided to pour there, that he's going to bring there. And that tells me that there's going to be a lot of healing we may not capture in our short 4-hour broadcast of TV that normally takes place there. So people are going to be healed at the gate, others are going to be healed on the way to the meeting, others will be healed on the roads where they wait to receive the man of God from town to town as they go. This kind of revival should not be taken for granted now. This is the longing of all nations of the earth that this visitation take place in their land. Because what the Lord has shown me, the fresh anointing, the beautiful anointing, the latter anointing, very aggressive anointing that is going to pour, is going to be a powerful anointing that will shake the nations of the earth. And so it is my cry that many, many, many nations may partake of this visitation. They may travel, who can travel, who can afford, travel and come and be part of this sacred visitation, this sacred assembly, this historic moment that has befallen the church. This is the most beautiful hour at which to be born again. This is the greatest hour for the church. This is the moment for the church. It's the watershed moment for the church. This is the hour at which it is wonderful and beautiful to be in holiness and to be found walking in righteousness. Because the fruit of righteousness is right now, instant here. The Lord is visiting the righteous church. The Lord is ascertaining, is affirming that surely, surely, yes, indeed, righteousness, righteousness is the way. Righteousness is the key. Righteousness is the blessedness of God given to men, given at the cross. And so we are seeing now the blessed fruit of the work of Jesus on the cross that gave us a holy salvation, a righteous salvation. But now the reward of the grace, the reward of the grace is the glory. The Lord is showing me that the glory will come down. He's showing me that the glory of the healing anointing will pour and many people will be set free. That is the reward. That is the reward of the grace and mercy that Jesus gave the church. So it's amazing that even before we enter eternity, as the church is sitting on the verge of eternity, already those who are righteous and holy are reaping the fruit, the benefit, they're reaping the reward of the grace of righteousness. May the nations prepare for the coming of the Messiah, because really these are very turning events. Shalom, shalom.